Hello everyone, welcome to Upptalk channel. In this tutorial video, we are going to discuss Salesforce Marketing Cloud. Before we start the video, let's know about Upptalk. Upptalk is a live, interactive platform for software training, furnishing robust personalities who could take on universal business platforms. Let's know about Workday Salesforce Marketing Cloud. The Salesforce Marketing Cloud is the customer relationship management, CRM, platform for marketers. This platform gives marketers the ability to develop and manage marketing partnerships as well as engage with customers. The topics we will cover in this video are overview on short code, long code, mobile connect. To know more about the latest and trending technologies, watch other videos on the Upptalk channel. Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel to know more about new technologies. This video will be covered by Mr. Rahul.
Send the SMS. And then we're discussing about the short code and the long code. And then, so what is the short code? So it is a 5 to 6 digit number. You must have seen like 5, 6, 7, 7, 8, and like all these short numbers that companies generally use if you want to send them bulk messages. You must have seen that the SMS coming from the mobile companies, right? Airtel, Jio. So they always use this short code, or maybe if it is coming from any other source, let's say Pizza Hut or any. So there are a lot of companies, they use the short code for the bulk SMS. So let's say Airtel wants to send this SMS to all the customers, that they have for the new product they have launched. Maybe they wanted to subscribe for the Airtel Music, right? So what they want to do, they want to send this message to all the customers that, okay, we see that, okay, you are using Airtel and all these things, and you might be interested in Airtel Music. So this is the subscription rate and everything. So if you want to inform about something to a large audience, then what you can do, we can use a short code. Or maybe in the TV shows, you must have seen that we get this voting option. That if you want to vote for your favorite participant, then you can type yes to this particular number. So something like that. There are some limitations with the short code, that they are limited to the national borders. What does it mean? That we have to procure the short code for a specific country. So if you want to communicate with the Indian customers, or maybe let's say US customers, then we have to have a short code which is applicable for the US. Now if you want to communicate with the Canadian customers, so we have to have a short code for Canada. So we have to purchase different short code for different countries. Short codes, that's what we discussed, that it is suitable for the local messaging, which means that it is suitable for the, or it is can only be used for the, for a particular country. So we cannot use a single short code to communicate with the customers from different countries. So this was about the short code. Now, what is a long code then? So long code is a name, so that it is a 10 digit number. It's a long code like our normal for my mobile number. And we can use a long code to send the and to receive text messages, faxes, and make calls. Whereas the short code is only limited to SMS and MMS messages. A long code, we generally use it for a one-to-one communication. So whenever a request is initiated, let's say if there's an order which got delivered and want to communicate to the customer. So that is a exclusive conversation, one-to-one. We are not broadcasting this particular message. So in that case, we can use the long code, and long code can be used to reach international customers. Means that we can use a single code to communicate with multiple customers or different customers coming from different countries. So generally we use short code. I've never seen long code being utilized in any of the project so far. So we generally rely on the short code if you want to send the SMS. The next thing is that we are going to look at the number of things or the different things that we require if you want to send the SMS. So we discussed maybe the short code and or the long code if you want to send the SMS. Apart from that, we need the audience, right, to whom we want to communicate. So we are going to store our customers either in the list or the data extension. So there are a few things that we need to keep in mind if you want to store the data on the list. And there are a few things that we need to keep in mind if you want to store the data in the data extension. So in case of list, what needs to be done? So if you want to send the email from email list, then what happens that we need to have the email address, right? And there has to be one field with the data type email address, and then like we'll be able to send the email. Otherwise, how marketing cloud is going to identify that, okay, in which field the email address is stored, because of the field type. So if I'll take you to here. Okay, so in Email Studio, the lists are called the email list, right? And we have mobile lists that are separate. So we do not use the email list to send the SMS. Okay. So lists that we can see over here, they generally have this email address field, and we store the email address value over here, and we can send the email. So for mobile communication, we have mobile lists. We can create one mobile list. We can import the data into mobile list, and we can send the communication to them. So in case of list, we need to have a field for mobile number. We need to have two-letter country code so that we can identify, okay, which country we are targeting, and then the contact key, because whenever the communication will be sent, it will be like on a contact key, right? So we need these three minimum fields if you want to send the SMS from a list. Now you want to send the SMS from the data extension, where things required. So we need to have a phone number field. Now we need to have this phone number field. Apart from that, the phone number that we are going to store in that field has to be normalized. Now, what is the meaning of a normalization is that, let's say we have this mobile number, it has got some special characters, like, you know, parenthesis, something like this. Let's say we have this 7 and 5, and then hyphen, let me just say 7, 8, 2, 3, 4, something like that, right? So it is not normalized. So normalization means that we have to remove all the special characters from mobile number, and then we have to have the country code. So let's say 91, or maybe if it is USA, then 1, okay, plus 1. But we won't be using the plus or something like this. So we need to have a field with the data type as phone number, and then we have to append the country code, and then our mobile number becomes the normalized mobile number. So that is the first requirement. Another one is that we need to have a field called locale. So we need to have a field with the data type as locale. So these lists are called the mobile lists that we can see over here. So when we click on the create list button over here, it asks us that how do you want to create the list. So we have the filtered list and create from file option. So these things we will discuss in detail when we come to the contact builder. For now, I just wanted to show you that we have separate list called mobile list in contact builder. So in case of list, these three things are required. In case of data extension, phone number and the locale field is required. What is locale? Locale tells you about the region. So we have locale for each country. For example, for USA, the locale is ENUS. For India, it is HIIN, right? Similarly, we have like locale for each and every country. Okay, and then we need to configure the help keyword over here in Marketing Cloud. So that what are the keywords? So keywords basically are the special messages for which the meaning is already predefined. For example, if I tell you that, okay, if you send me, or if somebody sends the stop as a message to the organization, then organization understands, okay, it means the unsubscription, and the customer does not want to receive any SMS message after this. If the customer will send the help as a message, then it means that, okay, the customer needs some assistance, customer needs some help, right? So the keywords are such words for which the meaning is already predefined. And whenever we receive a message which is a keyword, we understand, okay, this needs to be done. So you must have seen that. So whenever the voting, whenever we have this voting system in television, where they say that you have to type yes and then you have to send to this number, or maybe yes and then participant poll or something. So that is a keyword. So whenever we get one SMS message with this particular keyword or with this particular word in the SMS message, it means that we have to do something, or we know, okay, what does it mean? So if they say yes, it means that it will be counted as a vote for a particular participant. So we can create the keyword here. Then the paid message. So we have to obviously create the message so that we can deliver it, right? So let's talk about this now. So in Mobile Connect, we have two tabs, overview and the administration. In overview, we can see the different SMS messages that we have created, what are the different stats, keyword stats, and contacts. So what is the message stats? It shows us that how many messages that we have sent so far, or maybe like whatever the period that we want to choose. So how many messages we have sent, how many messages we have received. So it says, basically shows the message statistics. Next one is the keyword stats. So it looks something like this. So keyword stats. So let's say we have all these keywords configured, and we can see that for this particular keyword, how many responses we have got or how many messages we have sent. So whenever we want to send the SMS, we have to have a keyword associated with a short code. So how does it happen? So first we have to create a short code. I mean, we cannot create it over here, but we have to procure that. So we have to fill the form and then we get it assigned. So once we have the short code, in the administration tab, we can create a keyword. Now we can create the keyword as much as we want. I think the limitation is 1,000 keywords per short code. I'm not sure about the exact number, but I think it is 1,000 or 10,000. So those many keywords we can associate or we can create for a particular short code. Now, once we associate, it means that, okay, this particular SMS message is in relation with this particular campaign. So let's say we are creating one keyword for, for our Diwali discount. So what we'll say, we will create one keyword, Diwali offer. And then all the messages we will send with that particular keyword. Okay, for different purpose, we can create different keywords. And it says how many responses, how many messages that we have sent. In context, it shows us that how many mobile opt-ins that we have. So how many have opted in for the mobile communication in the last 30 days, and what is the growth? So let's say, the previous month they were 100 and now it is 150, right? So the total growth was like 50%, right? Or maybe like, let's say the previous month was 50 and this month is 100. So there's a growth of 100% in the contact opt-ins. Okay, and then we have the messages. We will be looking at this, how we can get the SMS message and what are different types of the SMS message that we have. We can generate a report over here, but since it is 00, so nothing will show up. We can add the contacts over here. So either we can import the file or we can edit manually. So when we click on this add contacts, it will take us to the contact builder, and there we can add the contact. In the administration, we have, first of all, the settings. Settings, tells us about whether we have enabled the non-GSM keywords or not. So, and then we have controls like bounce, logic, and hand list. So what does it do? So you must have seen, we talked about the subscriber's status, right? So in Email Studio, whenever the email is sent to any subscriber, and let's say the subscriber has faced bouncy or more bouncy in the last 15 days, right? Then what happens, the subscriber status gets changed to held. And when the subscriber becomes held, it means the marketing cloud is going to help, is going to exclude those subscribers from the email send so that they do not receive any further communication. Similarly, what happens over here is that whenever we are sending an SMS message to any customer and the customer faces any kind of bounce, maybe due to the server problem or maybe the mobile number is incorrect or because of any reason, the subscriber did not receive the SMS message and it got bounced. If you have enabled this logic, bounce logic, what it will do is that it will put that subscriber into the held list. Okay. So whenever a subscriber faces the bounce, it will put that subscriber into the held list. And once the subscriber is added to the held list, it means that they will be excluded from the further SMS communication. And the subscriber will not receive any further SMS message. If you want to disable this, we can disable. Then what will happen is that they will not receive. I mean, even if any bounces occur, the subscriber will not be added to the head list, and then they will not face an issue. Okay, so let me enable for now. And let's say we have. We want to send this SMS to these customers and they have been added to the head list, but now they are not being sent out because they are being excluded by the marketing cloud. So what we can do if we still want to send them the SMS communication, we can clear the head list, right? So if we will clear the list, it will basically remove all the subscribers from the head list, and then we will make them sendable again. So we'll be able to send them the SMS communication again. So this was the settings, and then we have the stored content. So you must have seen in email communication also, we have this form email address, form name, and these things, right? And we have the header and footer. So what we do, we generally configure it in the admin, and then so that we don't need to configure this again and again. So once we configure this in admin, we can just choose from here. So what we can do, we can write the, let's say, company name over here. This is our form name, or whatever you want to write. Let's say, SMS communication, something of that type. So whatever you want to write, we can write over here. And when we will choose the form name in our SMS message creation part, then it will basically appear over there, right? So we don't need to write it over there. We just choose the form name and it will be picked from here. Similarly, headers and footers, we can configure it over here. And at the time of the message creation, we will choose the headers. And then whatever the content that we have written over here, it will be fetched and then it will appear over there. So that we don't need to write it every time we are creating the SMS message. So let me just move this for now. Okay. Next is the send blockout window. So what is this? So blockout window means that this is the time period in which the SMS messages cannot go out. So generally, we do not want to send the SMS message in night. So we can set this blockout window that from 11 p.m. to 6 a.m. The message should not go out. So we can set the blockout window accordingly, and in night the SMS message will not go out. And this is the place where we can create the keywords. Since we do not have any shortcode configured, we are not able to create any of the keyword. Otherwise, we have got this option over here to create the keyword. So we click on that option and then we can create the keyword. Okay, now let's go and understand about the different messages that we can create. So you must have seen or you must have encountered different type of SMS messages in day-to-day life. So once at that topic, you receive this outbound communication, right? For example, you know, these companies, maybe Zomato, Swiggy, Airtel, right? Any company, and they send us this promotional email or maybe some delivery notification. So the communications where we have not initiated anything, right? If you are receiving this SMS message from a company, they are telling you, okay, this is a property which is available at, 50,000 rupees, something like that, right? So we receive these kind of communications a lot about the property deal or about some, you know, personal loan or something like that. So these are the things that we have not initiated, we have not told them to send us this to this particular SMS message. And there are some messages where we start. For example, we need to call the Dish TV, right? We are having some issue. What they do? And they tell us that, okay, you can send the help message or call me is a keyword, right? So call me to this particular number, 56768, something like that. So we send this SMS, call me to this particular number, and then we get the SMS back that, okay, we have got your request and our technician will call you back shortly, something like that. So in that case, we have initiated the conversation. We are the first one who started the conversation, who started the chatting, and then they will send us a response. So we'll understand that based on different templates, how we can configure these things. So first one is the outbound. So in outbound, the company is taking the entire responsibility to send the SMS, right? So here the customer is not involved, in initiating the conversation. So we'll provide the name, message name over here. And then we have to select the short code that which short code we want to use to send the SMS. Next one is the send method. Send method means that how do you want to send the SMS? So we have a couple of ways. So we will look at the automation, journey builder, and the API, how we can send the SMS. So a schedule means that if you want to send it via automation, for the journey builder, we'll show you. So in content builder, we can also create the SMS messages. So if you want to send the SMS using journey builder, then we have to create it in the content builder. So that we'll talk about in detail in a while. And then we have the API trigger. Okay, so we can choose any way that we want to use to send the SMS. Okay. We cannot proceed because we do not have a short code, and that is a mandatory field. So it will not let us to. Let us go ahead. Let me show you some of the screenshots so that you get the idea what it looks like. So we have 5 steps. Okay, so step number 3, it asks us for the audience. So here we can choose either a list or the data extension where we have is for the customer information. And in the 4th step, we have to define the content. Let's say your parcel is out for delivery and it will be delivered, today by 9 p.m. And these are the details or something. And then if you want to track your order, please click on this link, something like that, right? So we have to define the content that needs to be delivered. And then we have to activate or schedule this. So once it is activated, then we will use it for the sending. So okay, so this is the SMS message that we can send over here and these things. And then this is what it looks like when we receive the SMS message. Next one we have is next one we have is text response. So what does it mean? As it saying text response, it means that we are going to send the response, right? So when we send the response, when somebody will initiate the conversation. So we are going to create an automatic response to an inbound SMS message. So we talked about this example, right? So in Tata Sky or Distribute, what they do that they have this number, or let's say 12345, and you can send any SMS. I mean, let's say call me, or maybe you know, I need help or something like that. They have these keywords, right? So whenever we send the keyword to them on the given number, then we get this automatic response that okay, we have received a request and police shortly, or maybe some, you know, help documents or something like that. So how do we create it? So we'll click on the next button, and then here we need to again select the message name and the short code, and then we have call to action. So call to action means that how do we want to send the SMS? I mean, so here we must have been, can see that we do not have the audience option over here, because we do not know to whom we are communicating, right? Because we do not have a predefined or pre-configured audience list, right? So what's happening over here? Whenever we receive the SMS message from any of the customers, then we are going to respond to them, or we are going to send them the text message. So here we do not have any section to select the audience. So now let's move on to the third template. So there what we will do, we will configure the content, and we will activate that. And after that, we will, like, whenever we receive the SMS message using that particular keyword, then what will happen, we are going to send them a response. Next, we have mobile opt-in. So using mobile opt-in, we can invite people to opt-in for the mobile communication. So let's say, you know, we have this graphic, or maybe we have this thing going on, and we can place this on our website, or maybe on our shop, whatever, wherever we want to place, we can place this. And then we say that you can text guide in to this particular number. It means once you send this, we assume that okay, you have subscribed to the mobile communication, and we will be sending the exclusive offers or the SMS messages going forward. So it says guide into this, or maybe we can say we have this lifestyle store, right? So whenever you visit the lifestyle store, what they do is that, let's say on a billing counter, they have this you know, small card over there, and what it says is that okay, if you want to receive the exclusive offers or the ongoing offers, then you have to subscribe to our mobile channel or mobile communication. Then so this is called in-store signage. That is, we can do. Otherwise, we can have this on a website, and there also we can have the subscribers, have the customers to sign up or to subscribe to the mobile communication. So yeah. Next one, we have the email opt-in. So let's say if somebody has already subscribed to the SMS communication, and we have the right to send them the SMS. Then what we can do, we can tell them to subscribe to the email communication as well. Or we can have this initial signage which says that if you want to subscribe to the email communication, then we'll have to text this thing, guide, and then it says sending the email address to this particular number, so that you will start receiving the email communication. So many a times the offer, that like the information that we want to share with the customer, does not fit in the SMS message, because in SMS message we have a limitation of 160 characters. We cannot send more than 160 characters. So that is why you must have seen that we do not receive very long SMS message, right? There's always a short message. So that is why it is called the SMS. So we are limited to the 160 characters. And so if you want to share more information, what we can do? we can have them subscribe to our email communication so that we can send them the entire information. So here we have the message name and then the short long code, but you need to send it. Okay, one thing that I wanted to notice is that if you choose the outbound means that we are sending the communication from our side. So when we are sending from our side, we need the list of customers to whom we want to communicate. We need the audience, right? So that is why the third option is appearing over here. Now when it's changed to external source, then what happens is that the audience option goes away. Why? Because external source means that from any external source, we are receiving the SMS message. Now external source could be that they have seen this advertisement on a television or maybe on a website or somewhere else, but they are sending us the SMS message that okay, we want to opt into the mobile communication, or maybe we want to opt into the email communication, and then we are sending them the SMS that okay, we have got your email address and thank you for a subscription, and you will receive the web communication, something like that. And if we choose the third option, what does it mean? So now we will be able to send them the SMS as well, and we need to select the audience. Plus, we can also send the SMS message when we receive any SMS from the external source. So in the first option, we do not have any option to respond. So once we receive the SMS, we do not have any option to send a response that okay, we have opted in. So it is just for the outbound communication that we are telling them, or maybe we are inviting them that we see that you have subscribed to their mobile communication, and we have some more offers which are only available on the emails. So if you don't want to miss out on that, so please subscribe to the email communication, something like that. And in the external source, when we receive the SMS, we give them a response. And in the third option, the first two options will be applicable over here. So let me cancel this now. So since you do not have the short code, so we won't be able to see these things in action, that how do we send us this message and how do we receive it. But what you can do is that you can go through the entire thing, and then if you face any problem, just let me know. Okay. So we discussed about the overview and the demonstration, and then what are things that we require to send the SMS. Now in the mobile studio, we have another application called Mobile Push, which is used for the push notification. Sorry. So push notifications, as we discussed, that we can send this push notifications to the customers who have installed our application on their mobile devices. And with the help of the mobile push, we can send targeted and personalized push notifications for customers. We can send the inbox messages. We can segment the audience and then we can target them. So we can automate the campaigns and these things. So let's see this in action. So this is what it looks like. The mobile push application. Here we have the overview of how many messages we have delivered, how many messages were opened by the customer, the different applications, and the push opt-ins and everything. So let's say we have three different applications configured over here. So we want to check that how many have opted in for the push notification and the average time and all. And then we have the contest. So it says total opt-ins, and then we go through our last 3 days. And then the three push notifications that we have created over here. So we need to register one app, and we need to basically associate one app with the account so that we can send the push notification. So let's see how we can create the push notification in Content Builder. So we'll go to the mobile app, and then here we'll go to the push notification. And let's see how we can create it. Okay, so whenever we see the push notification, it has some different sections here. So it has some title and then some title and then message. So let's say we are setting the push notification, which says, okay, let's say it is from the Amazon, and what it says that non-soon offer, you know, live now, something like that, and then we grab your exclusive offer, you know, and then we can have the details over here, right? So we can see save 20% on every item you purchase. Okay. Something like that. And then we can decide the open behavior. That's whenever they click on the push notification, whether we want to redirect them to the application or maybe to any other app URL, web URL, or the cloud page. We'll discuss about the cloud page in upcoming session. Okay. If you want to personalize this, how we can do that? So let's say I want to personalize this with first name. Okay, so I'll write my first name. Okay, and we want to see the subscriber preview over here. So we select the data extension. Okay, I think the spelling is incorrect. Okay, so here we can see it is populating the first name of the customer, and then we have the gender text that we have written over there. So it will say hi Infas, hi Raj, hi Ram, right? So maybe we can personalize based on the first name or whatever the attributes that we have stored in our data extension. We can personalize the push notification, and we can also do it on different devices, like iPhone, Android, and what it looks like on Apple Watch. Okay, and then what is the short look and the long look. So there's something that we can see. Okay, so this is how we can create the SMS, sorry, a push notification. And once it is done, we can click on the save button, and then we can send the push notification. So let me just save this. So let's say Amazon monsoon offer notification. Okay, and I'll click on the save button. Similarly, what we can do, we can create the in-app messages. What they are. So whenever you open the application, right? So you might have encountered this thing that you receive this pop-up, and which might be, you know, for, let's say we are using the Amazon, and it asks us to subscribe to the Amazon Prime, right? Let's say that okay, today is 50% off in Amazon Prime or something like that. So whatever the offer that they want to give us. So either we can have on a full page, or maybe in the form of a banner, or maybe in the form of a modal. So let's say we want to go ahead with the full page for now, and we click on the next button. And then here it is showing as a full image and the crop image. So let's go ahead with the crop image for now. Similarly, what we can do, we can here configure all these things. So let's choose the image first of all. Or whenever we install the application, what happens is that it basically gives you the option to have a tour of the application guys. So let's say application tour, and then we can have the message as please click below button to start the application tour. And then here we can have start now, something of that. And then once they click on this, maybe we want to open a page in the same application or something like that. And we can, you know, have the URL over here so that it will start. So these are the different, like we also have this option to show and hide. So let's say if you don't want to show anything on this particular message, what we can do, we can just hide this and it will disappear from here. So based on our requirement, we can show and hide a particular section on the message. So this was the content, and then we have the designing. So in the design part, we can change the color, we can change the font size, we can change the font and things like that. So if you want to have a, you know, border color background and all these things. Okay, and we can also personalize this as well in the title or in the SMS message. Sorry, in the message or in the title, we can personalize this as well. We can say, first of all, welcome to the application or something like that. Let's say, oh, hi, and then first email, and then welcome to the app. Okay, something like that. And then it will appear the, and it will populate the first name of the customer over here. So let's save this. I will say, welcome in app message. Next, what we can do, we can create the SMS message here. So we can either create the SMS from here or from the mobile studio. So if you want to, so we have different ways to send the SMS. So if you are sending the SMS through Journey Builder, then we have to create it from here. And if you are sending the SMS from the automation, then we have to create the SMS message from the mobile studio. So we'll discuss about the journey and the automation in upcoming sessions. Here what we can do, we can type the message, or let's say any message that we want to write. Let's say we made one transaction, and then it says, okay, you have from spent, no, let's say 1,000 rupees, this 1,000, if this was not true, please call the below number or something like that. So we can have the message like this, and we can also have the personalization here as well. We can just add the personalization string, and then it will populate the personalized name or whatever it is. Let's say we have a number over here, and we can say that, okay, if you want to raise the concern, let's say raise the concern, user this and then we want to insert a link. But we are only limited to the 160 characters of the entire message. And if this URL is very big or very long, what we want to do, we want to shorten this. So we have this inbuilt feature. Using this, we can shorten the URL so that it doesn't take much of the characters, and we do not face this exceeding the 160 character limitation. Okay. So let's say in case we have more than 160 characters in our SMS message. So what is the general behavior of the SMS companies is that whenever they will, so we are going to send this SMS to the mobile companies, right? And they are going to send this to their customers. So let's say the customer is Airtel customer. So we are going to send this to Airtel, and then Airtel is going to deliver these SMS messages to their customers. So if it contains more than 160 characters, then it will basically split the message into two. Like first message will contain the 160 characters, and then the another message will contain the remaining characters. If we don't want that to happen, what we can do, we can click on this concatenate message, and then it will combine these two messages into one and then send it in one go. But from a billing perspective, Marketing Cloud is going to charge for two different messages if it exceeds 160 characters. So we just have to make sure that it is it should not exceed 160 character limit. Okay, and then here we can choose the code if we have that available. Okay. So in SMS message, we can describe the SMS message, we can add some personalization, and then we have to just save this SMS, and then it will be sent using the journey builder. So let me say bank transaction alert SMS. Okay. So we discussed about the mobile studio and the mobile push notifications, how we can create the SMS messages, what are the things that we require in order to create the SMS, and what are different types of the SMS messages that we have in Marketing Cloud, and their use cases and all.